Jai, Gopur Premanandi.
Where's the other mic?
Hi, Bo, welcome everybody. Hare Krishna, welcome to Shishi. Radha Govinda Mandir. You all probably have been here for the last few programs, but maybe one or two of you have not. So we'd like to welcome Sri Pad Bhakti Vishala Vishnu Maharaj. So this is his final class here in Alachua. So we'll be very sorry that today he's leaving after Prasad to go to Miami to continue his tour of to Tampa and then on to Miami. So if you want to follow him, you're welcome to. So Maharaj, as many of you know, he is a disciple of Sri Srimad Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Goswami Maharaj, who is a very prominent disciple of Sri Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And he is current Acharya and Shading Guru of the Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mission. And he spends much of his year traveling throughout Europe and America and South America to preach the glories of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and our Guru Parampara. We wish him, we'd like to thank him very much for coming and blessing us with his presence, and we beg that he will also return soon. We'd also like to welcome all of our God brothers and God sisters, also our respectable seniors, the disciples of Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Especially today, we'd like to welcome Shripad Rupa Nuga Prabhu, one of the very senior disciples of Srila Prabhupada. And of course, the Chaitanya Prabhu, Loka Guru Prabhu, and Gaurabinda Prabhu, and Sita Didi, Nita Saki, all Srila Prabhupada's disciples here. And also Jagadishwar Prabhu. I don't know if any of you know, this is Jagadishwar Prabhu. He came here from New Vrindavan recently. Today is also a very special day. It is the Tirubhav of Srila Bhakti Vallabhatirtha Goswami Maharaj. We have one of his disciples here. This is Shriman Abhimanyu Prabhu. And so without further ado, I will request Maharaj to speak some Hari Katha. Thanks.
Nandiham Sri Guru Sri Yuta Pada Kamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavanscha Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gauru Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Nama Hare Nama Hare Nama Iva Kevalam Kalu Nasti Eva Nasti Eva Nama Sankirtanam Yasya Sarva Papa Nasanam Pranamo Dukha Samanam Stam Namami Harim Param. By the mercy of our Guru Vargas and Sri Guru Gauranga and Radha Govinda, we are here together. I am happy with all devotees and mostly senior our God brothers, Nityananda Prabhu Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, Prabhupada's, all most devotees. They sacrifice their time, life to expand Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message, established temples, published books, and many things they have done. We can't believe how within a short time Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaja, our Sikha Guru and most
eminent who brought a laboratory to preach, and all his disciples from USA, they preached all over the world. So I am happy with all who are present here. Also, I want to listen something from senior Vaishnavas who are present here. So please give some words.
Anjakalpacharubhyasya kripasindubhyayakacha patitadangabhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavadibhavad
we were in Andhra Pradesh, and we had a 25-minute motion picture of ISKCON preaching all over the world, and we would show that in village after village. And I remember one time our projector broke, and we had to find one, and we got the man from the Indian Family Planning Group, and they had a 16-millimeter projector, and they showed our movie. Well, we have to operate this. I said, okay. And so they saw Krishna Consciousness, and I said to them, how does the family planning movement going on in India? He says, no, not so good. I said, why not? He says, people are saying one more mouth to feed is two more hands to work. So one time we set up a screen with a big cloth with a bamboo on top and a bamboo rod on the bottom. But I saw that I'm sitting behind the screen and the crowd is in front. I'm in the back with Puri Maharaj and others. And then I see that this corner of the screen is up, crooked. So I went around the front and I looked and it was down. It was all right now. I said, okay, start the movie. So we start the movie, about half an hour, the movie's over, and the lights go on, and it is Puri Maharaj who was holding the screen down for half an hour. Like this. This is someone I'm supposed to be putting on the high seat. He's sitting down there holding the screen down for us. Other people have other stories of how he provided for some people were leaving on the train. Does anyone know that? I may not be, but they were all leaving, they hadn't eaten, and he shows up with prasad. So this is Seva and Krinada Pisunichena. This is so humble. And he would do this very tedious service of just squatting down for half an hour. Hare
Krishna.
And I, since it is Tirtha Maharaj. Tirtha Maharaj was not active when I was at Madhav Maharaj's, not so much, but one time he had contacted chicken pox. And I told the group how they had chicken pox. And he said, I need to eat rich foods. He said, butter. I said, ghee? He said, no, butter. So I would bring him that white butter in the clay cups every day for a few days. And but when an older person gets chicken pox, it can be very severe. But he recovered. How old was he when he?
93.
So,
wow.
So maybe I helped. Then one time I had a program also, a big crowd on the stage in Calcutta, and he wanted to see, and so he came and he said, well, maybe I'll speak a little. And so I spoke a little, and then he spoke for 2 hours. Bhagavatam. For on, and questions and answers. And everybody in that mutt was a pundit. Look, and Bharati Maharaj, I was there when Bharati Maharaj was there.
You were also passing now.
And everybody, all the disciples, even any brahmachari, they were all pundit, bhakti shastris. Even some person who would just be mostly cooking or something, he would get up, I would take him to a village, he would take me to some village, and he'd open up Bhagavad Gita and speak for 2 hours on Shastra and Tattva, all of the journeys that are there. Okay. Pass the talking stick.
Seeing Chidananda Prabhu reminded me of a storefront in New York at 26 Second Avenue. One day we were sitting in a semi-circle, collating the first Back to Godhead magazine, which was actually a half a page on mimeographed paper, and the front was a colored paper, and the back was nickel. It was stapled together. Nobody would accept it because it wasn't.
Oh, I'm sorry. No one would accept it because it wasn't glossy. It wasn't a glossy magazine. So this first attempt was just on a mimeograph machine that was ended up in the basement. But the first ISKCON press was a mimeograph machine, a huge mimeograph machine. It took up a lot of space when you came in the storefront, so it eventually ended up in the basement. So we were there sitting in this semicircle, 4, 5, 6 of us, collating this first Back to Godhead magazine. And suddenly Srila Prabhupada walked in the door. We weren't expecting, we didn't know. He went out for his walk by himself. And he walked in the door, and we all paid our obeisances so quickly, so reverently. And he walked briskly by and said, "Don't stop working, don't stop working!" And went out the side door. And that was the mood. We had a big job. The country was 3,000 miles wide, and we were supposed to cover a handful of persons. And then we had the good fortune to
make an album,
a record, a happening album. We went to not a very fancy studio. It wasn't even a stereo, it was just a monaural studio. We made this record. We didn't even have any real instruments. Actually, Shapapa had only a pair of cartels, never back in the storefront. So we were playing all kinds of things, whatever we had. I was playing two little bells that had the little pieces sticking out, you know, and you could ring them. So I was just playing the bells myself. And the man who was in charge, the engineer, came around and he was holding a mic to see just which instruments would be acceptable. So he came around to me, and I was hoping, because I played this every kirtan at the temple.
I would play the same two little bells.
I would play it. So, "Oh, you've got to let me play this bell." So he did. And another one. And Hari Guru was playing the tambura. And didn't miss a beat for both sides of the album. It's amazing. And Kirjana was pumping on the harmonia. We weren't very talented. You know. So I was playing the bells and somebody else. Brahmananda was playing, was clapping so loud we had to take another take. We had another take. Played it back, it was clap, clap, clap. So we had to do again. And on the way, we came out of the storefront, we were headed for the studio. A young couple was coming to visit. So he said, "Oh, we're going to make a record, come on." So they said, "Yes, we'll come." So they came on, never saw them again. They sat in for that record. And it so happened that that album made its way to London. Made its way to London where George Harrison and John Lennon heard it. And they went and played it for 3 days on a boat. And that was their introduction to Krishna consciousness. It was a little, on one side was a gas station, another side was a laundromat, across the street was a money bag factory, and next to that was a funeral home.
location. It was on the edge of the whole East Village section. And the storefront before became a little temple. It was called Matchless Gifts. Very appropriate. Remember, I used to go to work, and I passed that little store, and it said Matchless Gifts. I thought, this store is so far away from the track, the beaten track. It will not stay. So it actually, another time I came by on the way to work, and it was empty. The next time I came by on the way to work, I looked inside, and I saw people in robes. I thought, Buddhists. They're Buddhists. I don't like Buddhism. So I just kept going. But someone came to the door and said, won't you come in? I said, no, I've got to work, which was true, but I didn't like Buddhism, so I just went on. And then later on, actually, someone from a Guru Nanak disciple gave me a book called Sarvashan, in which it said, you've got to have a spiritual master. If you have a spiritual master, he'll take you around and show you all the upper planets. And I thought, because I was oriented toward what's out there. So I said, oh, I've got to find a spiritual master. Because I was not an atheist, but I was thinking at the time. So next thing I know, I saw Srila Prabhupada in the park chanting Hare Krishna. And if someone walked up to me and said, this man just got out of that rocket ship over behind the trees, I wouldn't believed it. I wouldn't believed it because he was from another world. I could see that. So I chanted along with him, and my wife and took our baby son, 2 years old, it's a boy, took him strolling somewhere, and I just kept chanting. And that was the beginning of how I met Srila Prabhupada in the park. Actually, there was a newspaper there printed by the local hippies called the East Village Other. And Srila Prabhupada was on the front page by the tree there. And it said, this is the last Sunday the Swami is going to be there. And I read that and I thought, I've got to go. It's the last day he's going to be there because it's getting cold. New York, October was cold for him. So I went. And just before that, I had been in the local shop called the Head Shop. It was the first head shop. And it was just filled with drug paraphernalia stuff, bad books. And I was there visiting and I looked. In the corner, there was a brown-looking books, looked very old, looked foreign. So I walked over to them, and I didn't know, but they were the Bhagavatams. The Srila Prabhupada brought from India 200 sets of Bhagavatams, so one set made it into the head shop. So I picked it up, I looked at it, and I seem to remember something about Parikkhit Maharaj. I started reading it, and I said, this is too advanced for me. Put it back. I didn't realize that it was Srimad Bhagavatam Srila Prabhupada brought with him. So that was just, I'm just explaining to you how I accidentally stumbled into this great movement. And I'm actually very proud to be here because Srila Prabhupada's preaching has made all these things happen. We owe him much for that. And when I heard Srila Prabhupada say he had godbrothers, I was taken aback. I was thinking, godbrother? What is a godbrother? What is that? More? There's more? So I'm very pleased to, over the years, finally meet more. When I met Sri Maharaj in Mayapur, in Sri Prabhupada's quarters, I was so happy to meet more Vaishnavas. You see, when we were in the storefront, the word Vaishnava, we would never think of it, calling ourselves Vaishnavas. We thought the Vaishnava was like so elevated that we could be candidate Vaishnavas, but we wouldn't think of calling each other Vaishnavas. He was training us to call each other. To the preaching work, there's so many devotees who can think like that. But Vaishnava is very elevated. Position. And we always thought like that. And Srila Prabhupada taught us how to pray, obeisance to each other. So the custom was, the first time you saw a godbrother or godsister in the morning, you would say, Haribo, all glories to Srila Prabhupada, please accept my humble obeisances. And go down and pay your respects. So he taught us humility from the beginning. And I think that's what keeps us moving. Humility that takes to preach. Because it's a preaching movement. And certainly Srila Prabhupada was Srila Prabhupada's disciple. Srila Prabhupada was the embodiment of the preaching spirit. He was certainly, because of what he did. He proved that Lord Chaitanya's movement could spread around the world.
Yeah.
And that's very glorious. Thank you.
So that first album that they made in that studio, there's another part of a story. There's a famous disc jockey Beyond All Night doing avant-garde music, you know, cool music. And he got a hold of this album and he played it. And he thought it was so cool, he played it again. And he kept playing, he played it all night long. And people were listening to it. Pushkar said that he heard it, he heard it on that station, and right. Probably others. But just interesting little tidbit. And in 1980, I was fortunate enough to go to India, and I was shopping for our deities in Washington, D.C., Shishi Radha Madan Mohan. And somehow or other, I was meeting different of Prabhupada's godbrothers, just by chance. And I went to Puri, and I was told by a close friend of mine, Krishna Gopal, that, not Gopal Krishna, but Krishna Gopal lives in the area somewhere. He said, you should go see Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Maharaj. At that time, he was known just, I think, as Puri Maharaj. And so I went to the temple on the main street in Puri. It's the place where Srila Bhakti Siddhanta was born, in a home owned by Thakur Bhakti Vinod, just down the street from Jagannath Temple. So I was fortunate enough to meet Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Maharaj. And he was in his 50s, I think. And he was extremely, extremely humble. He said, wait here. And he went to the Puri temple and got us prasad from Puri temple, because, you know, of course, Westerners are not allowed to go. And he brought it back, and I just couldn't believe it, that someone who was a sannyasi, who I'd never really even met, would take so much care. Serving someone, you know, just a lowly person like herself. And he gave some couple instructions, and I follow them to this day. One is, I always had my japa bead bag would always sit on my lap, and he took it and tied it so it would be up like this, never touching my lower part of my body. So I tried to do that since then, and he said some other things. And I just, I'm so happy to meet a disciple of his who possesses that same humility. That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah. disease, our wisdom is in. We share each other our experience, how we realize the qualities of Vaishnavas, our Guru Vargas, and that their compassion, their mercy, their love. Without any their any selfishness, thus they are thus giving their mercy, compassion to us, to bring the conditioned soul from the material condition to Krishna, to spiritual. That is this causeless mercy. There is no any cause. We have seen in our Guru Vargas, they don't want anything. They have no desire anything to get in this material world. They completely surrender to Guru and Vaishnavas and they sacrifice their time, their life, their intelligence, how to bring this jivas to Krishna. Actually, another point there came from spiritual world. If we see in the material condition, no one can, free from their sense gratification and mental attraction, all kind of this material maya, the Supreme Lord's maya is so attractive and powerful, no one can free from this. Even demigods, even who are celestial body living with the sattva guna, goodness, nature also, they are under the control of maya. No one come out from this maya. So, who are preaching in this world without any kind of their own attraction for this maya, same time they also sacrifice themselves to serve others, to serve to Hari Guru Vaishnavas, giving them Bhagavata Gita, this knowledge which is coming by Parampara and the Supreme Lord for the human, how they come out from this maya. They have given so much unlimited knowledge there. Everything is here knowledge. This maya, also that there is knowledge to how to know this maya, how to engage the maya, how to enjoy the maya, how to find out the how many energies there, many scientists, many intellectual philosophers, they are also engaged their time, life to know the maya. These three modes of nature, this energy, the 25 elements, as explained in Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. And about know this body, they have also many scientists, laboratories, they are always researching to know how many germs there, how many chemicals there, how many all minerals there, they are also researching and discovering medicine, everything they are doing, all this. But no one can able to free from this maya, to understand this maya, and what about the Supreme Lord. And they don't accept this Supreme Lord is a person. They cannot accept this. They except there is a superpower, there is a super nature which controlling, which doing, they know this discovery, something, but no one can able to accept the Supreme Lord is a beautiful, very youth and very attractive and very Sachidananda. It's very difficult to them to accept this. because this is achintya, inconceivable, no one can understand. Only by His mercy, one can understand, like adding in the Brahma's prayer in Bhagavatam. Athapi te deva padambhuja dvaya prasadale shanum gruhitai vahi janati tattam bhagavan mahimno nanyat egopi chiram vichinnam chiram vichinnam api chiram vichinnam. Or if someone researching to know is to know about you, chiram, this all its life, all time, if they cannot understand, cannot know anything, anything about you. If you have some little one drop of your mercy from your feet, then only they can know to you. If somebody says, I know about you, God, about you, then maybe they know. I don't want to say anything about them. Janant eva janant kim bahuktyanami. They know, maybe they know, I don't want to say anything to them about them. But I am saying, manaso bapuso bacho, my mind, my body, senses, my words, I don't know anything about you.
So, how?
A ordinary jiva can know this. Only this jiva, they need love. They need asraya. They need shelter. Because here in Bhagavatam, mainly the central, the important point is written, asrayascha visuddha tattvam navanamiha lakshanam. These 10 symptoms of Bhagavatam. Atra sargo visargascho sthana poshana mutayaha manvantara ishanugatha niruddha muktira asraya. These 10 symptoms. Next verse, Sukadeva Goswami told, asrayascha visuddha tattvam navanamiha lakshanam. This asraya tattva means this jiva needs shelter, needs some support, needs some shelter, because here it's no shelter. All are moving by the kala, by the energy, all moving. Now we are moving, everything is moving, air, fire, sun, God, and stars, ocean, this, everything moving, our inside also moving, mind is moving, and body, blood, everything is moving, nothing is stable here. So this soul is unsecured here. It's no any thing here, to whom to believe, whom to, they will stay. Maybe they are where they are living, like here, okay, we will make one house, and we have some wife, think, oh, husband will give me shelter, husband think maybe wife will give me shelter, and if I will get children or government and this weapons or many things, they think like this, but all are under control of the kala, the time and the nature. See, so the soul needs shelter. So who will give them shelter? And who are giving them shelter and they say love, they have some also desire to get from them. Something they want to enjoy with them, to enjoy to them. So really no one have such capacity to really, they want to help them and to love them without any kind of selfishness. Only if in this world, even if we compare in Bhagavatam told, Deva, Karma, Sachiva, in demigods, they are also selfish. How we will act, they will give. If we do wrong, they will give wrong result, they punish. If they, we do good things, they will give something good result for material things. But how to free from here? No one is in this world. Only his devotees who are so much compassion, love, unlimited. Even Swayam Bhagavan Krishna also, he wanted to take shelter in their heart. He told himself in Ambarisha and Durvasa's this pastime. When Durvasa went to Krishna, Narayana, before he was not an ordinary person, he was a powerful, perfect stage. He has all perfection. He can go to different, he went to heavenly planet, go to Kailasa, he went to Brahma's place. He went to also Vaikuntha to meet him. And he knows all this Sadhi Janima, Langima, Mahima, Isita, Basita, all these siddhis also with him. But Sudarshana Chakra was
following to him.
And last moment he arrived there in Vaikuntha. Mahadeva told him, Brahma told him, you, no one can save you. You go to him whose weapon this. So he went there. Then he prayed, Namo Brahmanya Devaya Brahmana Hitaya Jagadhitaya Krishnaya Vindaya Namo Namo. In many verses he offered him, please, I am suffering by your weapon. Please give me shelter. I have not done any wrong. He invited me, Ambarisha. Without my presence, he already ate. It was his. Why he want to punish, to destroy? Because he want to show the dharma that you invited. One says, and before he to feed him, how you can eat? Mm-hmm. He did not know about all this devotional bhakti. Ekadasi, how to, he did not, he was a yogi, he was a very powerful tapasvi. By his words, Indra also lost his heavenly planet. Everyone afraid to Durvasa, he is the son of Akri, Brahmarsi, Anushaya. And also he came from Mahadevas, his three. Mahadevas came Durvasa, Brahmas came Chandra, and Vishnus came Dattatreya. Three, they became their sons. So it is not ordinary. Then Lord, Supreme Lord explained it to him what is the power of bhakti and what is his position. He told, you came to me, but come to me before. You also went to Indra, you went to Brahma and the CEO and others. No one saved to you. Why? They are under me. They are under my control. So they could not able to control, they can say to you. But you know me. I am aham bhakta paradhina asvatantra ivadvija sadhubhi grasta hrudayam bhakti bhakta janapriya. My character, you know who, my position. I am my devotee's control. My devotees, Ambarisha, he was a king, he gave up everything. He did not anything doing for himself. He came, 4 months he was offering, fasting and maintaining Chaturmasya, and also Ekadasi he performed in Vrindavan. Actually his kingdom, his palace is Ayodhya. He is coming from some dynasty. But he came to Vrindavan to perform this Chaturmasya Vrata and Ekadasi he was performing. And he invited you. Why he invited you? To please me. Because I like to
Brahmins and Sadhus.
So I please with them. So he invited you to feed to you. But you don't know, understand, you
went to Yamuna and
you meditated there and time was passing, Ekadasi time passing, so he took little water and he did not eat anything, Nirjala, and did not sleep before they were doing. Whole night they are performing the Sankirtana and hearing Puranas, worshipping. So, he did not eat. You have no patience to know. When you came, you became immediate angry, and you want to kill him. But you know, he did not eat. He is still waiting there for you. And with his family, his wife, his children, they did not eat. And they are waiting for you also. Why you became so angry? How many you have mystic power? How many maybe you have qualities? But this little anger can burn to you everything. This anger in one morality, they told the anger is more powerful than poison and fire. If fire will burn, then it comes to outside. Burn. Poison, if we take, also take a time to go to blood and come to brain to suffer. But this anger, within 1 second, he can burn to you from inside and outside. He can do everything. So this anger lost your all power. I cannot save you, but you go, I am giving this option, solution, you go, he will save you. Then he understand, and he told, I am sadhuhi grastahudayam bhaktiri bhakta janapriya. My character is bhakta janapriya, who has no any kind of this material desires, and who wants to me, please me, serve to me. I am also want to with them same. Others what they want, that is business. For the benefit they want, sending the certification, they are what they do. But it is different for me, my character to such gate, such pure persons, devotees. I am taking shelter to their heart. So, we need shelter. We need shelter. Actually, Asrayasya Vishudhavartham Navanam Hyalakshanam. In Bhagavatam, he told Asraya. Asraya means we need some shelter. All are refuge here. We are all came here. We are moving here. We have no peace. We have no steadiness. We have no any kind of security here. Maybe we create many insurance for medical insurance, for house insurance, for everything we want insurance, but nothing is insurance here. Only money insurance. Yeah. That we are this all false our conception, false our activities, everything we, but really we need. Because now we are moving by Kala Chakra. Durvasa was also moving, is following to Sudarshana Chakra. But also Kala Chakra is Krishna's Chakra, which is moving, all are moving here. Also demigods, in Brahma Loko, in Satya Loko, Jana Loko, Tapa Loko, Mahara Loko, Sarga Loko. This is Murtyu Loko, Bhu Loko, immortal planet we are here. And also other Lokas, what Bhagavata explained this. So, among all this human body, only human body, has this opportunity to serve to the God and to free from here. In this body, had all kind of realization. We know what is the truth, what is untruth, what is distress, what is happiness, what is the life. We have this experience. We see, we hear, we touch, we enjoy this, and we know what is this. if we go to realize from our birth, how much we can remember. How we grow up, how we pass our time with our senses, mind and every
day. If we think this,
remember this, immediately we will get detachment. Vairagya immediately come from only by this body has given. Also knowledge coming, intelligence coming when we see to others, how they die, how it is the condition of this. When we see this, we know this. If we really we want to do this, we will get the truth knowledge, the reality there. We can get knowledge,
satya, jnana, vairagya,
also bhakti. So bhakti is very difficult to understand. So who is Supreme Lord? Who is real Lord? There are many Lord, many religion, many things also there. How one can find that someone is Supreme Lord? If we come to know Bhagavatam, which is Vyasadeva has given his complete, his
conclusion
in Bhagavatam, very difficult to
come to Bhagavatam,
to understand Bhagavatam, to know the Bhagavatam. This is also, if we have good person, then we can get. If we get like a one book, we cannot understand. We must hear from a devotee, a Bhagavata, person Bhagavata. Then we can understand. Otherwise we can't understand. So in Bhagavatam, it is given this Asraya. Who is the Asraya of? Who is the shelter of everything? This Maya, this energy, also this Jiva. Who is actually behind it origin? So the Supreme Lord Krishna, by the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, we got this in Kali Yuga. This Bhagavatam also we come to understand, and also the process, practical process, they who are preaching, coming to preach, they are also not this ordinary, they are these jivas. Because in Bhagavatam he has written, Kritadisu Prajaradhan Kalu Sambhavam Ichatam Kalu Kalu Sambhavanti Narayana Parayanaha. In this Kali Yuga, all the Narayana Parayana devotees will appear here and they will preach. They will give them the mercy to take them to spiritual planet. Therefore, Kritadisu Praja, in the past Yuga, Krita Yuga, from their population, their people, that time they also pray, we will take a bath in Kali Yuga and we will come to the, get this prema to go to the Guru Vrindavan. Because other times was not available this. Because Bhagavata Gita, what we have this before, it was not so easy to get. We now, everybody, we see every house we can find, and only one small machine of everything is there. This is not available that time. Also, it's bed also there. If you see something that you can use for also sinful activities to go to hell, at the same time also available to go to Vrindavan. Also this Sankirtan process, Sankirtan, this happily music, dancing, chanting with the bhava, with your melody, this is the highest pleasure for the body, mind and soul. So if by this process one can attain to the Supreme Learning, attain the prem. It's not ordinary things. It is only mercy for Kali Yuga people and our Guru Vargas. They all came from spiritual planet and they distribute their compassion to them, and they also now also they are there, Prabhupada, there, Guru Varagam. We think, they'll went away, or they are maybe go to Nityalila, or they are not here, no. They are also there, but we have a connection with them. If we now remember, we can connect with them, because the energy, the relation never lost. When we become opposite, means we lost connection, relation with them, we cannot remember them, maybe we do offense, enemy, envious with them, then we change. Otherwise, this bhakti dharma, so powerful, never loss. If we do something, if we offer it to Krishna, little water, flower, fruit, something, always it is existing with Krishna. Name Bhakta Pranasyati, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna told. Salpam apesya dharmasya trayati mahato bhayas. If we do little dharma also, it save us very dangerous. Even death time, which is most important, Bhagavad has written. When we lost everything in this world, with the body, with everything, but what will be with us? If we did something selflessly to serve to the Supreme Lord, to Guru and the Vaishnavas, it will never lost. No kala, the time cannot destroy this. Bhagavatam told, Ayo harati vaipunsam udyana astancha dannasau tasyarte jatakhyananitam uttamasluka vartaya. He told, Ayu means the time, lifetime. Harati, every day, sun is appearing, east and west, going to west, and always they taking of their time, lifetime, day by day. But who are staying with Uttamasloka Vartaya? This kala cannot take their time. Means this is existing. So at how much we spend our time, our mind, our intelligence, our energy with Krishna and his devotees for any purpose. Even someone also for doing service to Tulsi or garden or sweeping the marjana, anything they do, that is also loss, that is also give them to free from this material world. This is guaranteed there in Bhagavata. We must go to deep, to understand this knowledge. This bhakti dharma, this Vaishnava dharma is not material. This is spiritual. This is bhakti coming from the internal potency of the Sri Krishna. This bhakti, this is separate. Even 11th canto, when Krishna explained to Uddhava, he told Vishwadruhopi, if someone became so sinful to whole universe, even devatas, demigods also. But when surrender to Krishna, he become saint. Bhagavad Gita told, Abhijeto Suduracharo. Duracharo means who is a sinful person, who is doing all kind of adharma. Duracharo. But another one he gave, the Suduracharo, means very, very, very sinful. But he became also Sadhureva Sava, if surrender. Surrender means, this is a different, Saranagati, devotion is surrender, no one will surrender. If somebody surrender, maybe for some benefit they get, some job, work, they are also surrendering them, but for some purpose. In government also, military, police, they surrender to government, but for money, for something they are having such condition. But without any condition, who surrender to the Supreme Lord, they will free from this maya mame vaje prapadyante mayame tam karantite. Krishna told. So, baby maya, Moha Maya Durattaya. So only by surrendering, whenever they have ego, they cannot go out from here. This ego needed to surrender. Thus they say, I and my just change to your servant. You are mine and I am your servant. Yes, we connect with this. This is Dasa. Some story told, Shankaracharya came. He told Soham. Soham, I am same. Brahma. He told, no? Brahma. Brahma jiva brahmeiva kevalam. I am also Brahma. Soham, sa, aham. Sa Brahma, I am also Brahma, he told me. Then Ramanuja, that the Vaishnava came. Then someone doing japa, soham, soham, chanting, soham, 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 I am not this body, I am this fire, I am not this air, I am not this ether, I am not this, this, I am soham. Then Ramanuja told, no, no, soham, no, you put another da. Dasoham. Chanting Dasoham, Dasoham, Dasoham. Then again, another came, going, oh, you are chanting, we are doing mistake. I am same. So he put another sa. Sadasoham, Sadasoham. Always I am soham. So again, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to him. Times came again, he told, another das. So daso daso om, daso daso om. So I am dasa anu dasa. We are a servant of dasas dasas. But devotees by this channel. So great Vaishnavas our Guru Vargasu, and today also Nityananda Swabhavati Vallabha Tirtha Gosvami Maharaj, he was also Acharya of Chaitanya Gaudiya Math. And then we have one World Vaishnava Association, he was president. Also, I was from beginning, I am also there, vice president there. We have many meetings. So simple, so sarala, so humility, we can't find. If we go to them, we don't feel I am separate. We think they are so close with their heart, they love and they give their affection, we cannot believe. This is nature of Vaishnavas. Whom we serve, or example, if we go to Krishna to serve, who is Krishna? If we serve to Krishna, means we have to serve to Krishna's family also. So who is Krishna's family? Whole world is Krishna's family. So we have to serve to them also. We cannot go. And if we want to serve one part and we beat another part, this is not service. For example, to understand, one guru has many disciples. So one guru, the two disciples came and they were servicing. Servicing means they are massaging the leg. Then these disciples, they say, oh, this is my leg. And he says, this is my leg. You don't touch my leg. You do your. Then after the time, they are, you know, ignorant like children. They say, my mother. You don't come. If one mother have 4, 5, 6, then he is going to, no, this is my mother. I have to sit in the lap. You cannot come. So like that. Then one doing service to one leg, another service to me to another leg, they think this is my leg, this is my guru's leg, my leg. Then after some time, maybe one could not come, so he told, okay, you do message to this. Then he told, no, this is his leg. Their ignorance. They think this. Then he was messaging, another disciple came and he will, oh, why are you servings to my leg. Then what he did, he brought one stick and he was beating it to his leg. He forgot this is Guru's leg. This is the childishness of ignorance. They think this is mine. This is my Krishna. This is your Krishna. Your Krishna and my Krishna. Because they go to buy in Lohi Bazar. Jayapur. You can bring one, by a few thousand rupees, you can buy on a Krishna. Then you can give this is my Krishna. This is your Krishna. So this is material conception, Kanishtha mentality. With this material energy, we think, oh, this is mine, this is your, this is his. Institution are a guru. Guru tattva also same. Vaishnava tattva also the same. That this is not material things. We cannot divide. We cannot make, we cannot break, we cannot give, we cannot take, we cannot keep. This is not material things, we can do this. This is spiritual. This is inconceivable. This is Krishna consciousness. If we divide, then we become divided. Means we want to Krishna to divide. So Krishna will not happy with this kind of mentality. Then what will he do, Guru? Now they beat to his Guru's leg. They divide Guru's leg among them. And they want to quarrel among themselves. And they beat to his leg. So what will do, Guru? Guru will take a stick and both of your rascals go out from here. You are not qualified to serve. You are not qualified to serve. You don't understand. You don't have knowledge. Mature. So this kind of mentality, generally because all are in a material condition. But if we see, we go to these such devotees, how they have heart. Maybe they are living under a tree. Goswamis, they left everything. They live in under a tree. Not only one tree, one day one tree also. But the heart was holy universe, Krishna there inside. Haridas Thakur, he was living, there is no places. They are living in Ganga, in some caves, there is something living. But taking all his this burden, this pains, this death, exactly his Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Only Krishna is there. Kunti's prayer, she told. Janmaiswarya Sruta Srivi Edhamanaha Paraha Puman Naiva Santivhi Abhidhatam Vang Akinchana Gochara. By birth, high class birth, Aishwarya, who has wealth, Aishwarya, Sruta, who has knowledge, already who study Veda and the knowledge they have, Sri, they have beauty and all opulence there. By this, no one can able to realize Krishna. To you, he told, she told. Why you are Akinchana Gochara? Who has nothing in this kind of this ego, prestige, dignity, all kind of this material designations, upadis, they can able to understand you, to realize you. She told this. So how they have such kind of akinchana? They have everything, but they don't think this is belongs to them. Everything belongs to Krishna. Only we are servants, we serve to him. What name? So this is the Vaishnava's qualities. And Srila Nitalapsa Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj today also he is such Sai. When I met with him and Puri, Chaitanya Gaudiya Mata, there also he feels same, comfortable. They give the immediate calm and feel in prasadam, this, that, would never feel such love, Vaishnavas. That he told this. When I saw our Guru Maharaj, when any devotees come, Western devotees come, also Prabhupada disciples come in Visakhapatnam, they come for the make, like making life membership, you know. So they come, says Maharaj, so exciting in the Rajamandri, in Puri, Garampur, all our temples, so they come. So, compassion, himself will give prasadam to them also. So they have no any kind of anything, but they have compassion, how they can grow up and preach and they can free from this material world, same time also they preach to others. This is the best service, topmost service for human society. Very difficult to understand this. Many they are saying, okay, we will give some refugee, some house, some maybe financial support, some food, some cloth. They think this is greatest donors. They are doing good to get big service. But our vision is not like that. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Swami Thakur told, if someone construct 100 hospitals, 100 of these charities, and 100 hospitals and schools, but who are in this prison, in the jail, what maybe we give them, they will not happy. So if we need 200 gallon chitrakta, spiritual blood, to take out one jiva from this material world, that is more superior donation from others. This is most charity from others, so what they do, under hospital like this. But it is very difficult to understand, because in this material condition, all are covered by these three moods of nature. They don't know about their soul, they don't understand what to do and what is real. So very difficult to also convince them to know them. Then another is practice, how to come out from this practice. Many people, they come, they hear, they attract. But when we say, okay, you give up the fish, meat and the alcohol, all these things, then they also, some don't come, they don't practice these things. Then again comes someone coming here, in regarding the temple, they are coming, they stay sometimes, after sometimes also they lose the faith and they also quarrel with them, make also some offenses. So because need the Shastra knowledge, without scripture knowledge, deep scripture knowledge, no one can understand how to advance in bhakti, from kanishtha to go to madhyama, madhyama to go to uttama. They need deep knowledge, this Shastra knowledge, our Guru Bharat, they gave us. So, Vaishnavas, this quality, how we have to embrace whole universe, love whole universe, respect whole universe, respect to Krishna and his beautiful creation, and his beautiful management, everything going perfectly. Nothing is going beyond the control of Krishna, beyond the control of Kala. He is the Kala, you know. Everything is at control. What maybe we see, some demoniac quality, sinful activity, this, that, but everything is going on perfectly. He is the control, supreme controller. And this is also part of his creation, this Leela. This is Srishti Leela. That is the Nitya Leela. So this is everything going on. We no need to be worried for anything. Oh, something happened, this, that, everything, no, everything is under his control. Mahavartha, he saw everything, you know. Everyone, they are thanking him. By Krishna only, Gandhari told by Krishna, she lost all her sons. Also, Draupadi told by Krishna, she lost his sons. Subhadra told by Krishna, Abhimanyu dead, so she lost. And Jadu wants by his own dynasty, she also finished this. But that is the temporary this body. We are all bodily concept. With the body we think this only I am this. So they also think this. In Mahabharata, and after war, Vyasadeva came and discussed with his family. They are all Pandavas there. Only 10 people was there, Pandavas 5 there. So, no one there, all have healed. Then he came and all ladies there, Pandavas there, Draupadi, Kunti, Gandhari, Dhritarashtra, all there. They went, the Vyasadeva came, they cry. Because Vyasadeva only, he was their forefather, no? Grandfather. So, then Vyasadeva, all they see, they all cry because of they among themselves the dead, Yudhishthira also, Bhima, Arjuna, Nakula, sorry for that. Vyasadeva asked them, what shall I do for you? You become happy and peaceful. Then no one able to speak. Dhritarashtra was crying because Dhritarashtra was the main
cold.
So crying, then Gandhari told, oh father, your son, means Dhritarashtra's son, your son, after this war, he never sleep night time, always crying. He always saying, my sons are so sinful, what they have done in this war. Bhishma, Drona, Sahaja, such great persons also, they left their life. So after death, what happened to them? Maybe go to hell, suffering or what they do. So he is always repeating same thing. So please give him how he can get peaceful. Because could not sleep, he becomes sick. This was the daily complaint. Then Kunti told, I cannot sleep because Karna was my son, but for me, he suffered and he joined with Duryodhana. So I did this mistake to him. When I think I cannot sleep, then nothing give me peace. Then others also, they asked, Draupadi asked her sons, Subhadra asked about Abhimanyu. And they lost their, then Vyasadeva told us, okay, come. Evening time we will go to Ganga. And we will offer oblation and we will come. Then evening time they all went there. Ganga. Vyasadeva called them. All they saw with their own form. They saw there, Karna was with the sun god, Abhimanyu was the moon, she was moon. And this Duryodhana's 100 brothers, they are, their names are there in Jakshas. They came from there. All their name with their own form was there. When Vyasadeva called, all they came. When they saw them, then they became peaceful. They think, oh, my son, I left, my son, my this, my whose son, which this is Leela going on. They are, they came, their body finished again, they go to their own far. All demigods, they came, who demons came there. When they saw, then they offer also the oblation tarpana to them. Then they became quiet. They think, oh, dead, everyone dead by this, that. Who is dying? Nothing is dying. Soul is only changing this like a dress. We know from beginning of Gita. Pasanchi jirnani jatha vihayo navani kurnati narokurani tatha sarirani vihayo jirnani nati samjati navani dehi. Krishna told this is like a dress. Became old, you throw and take another body, another dress. This is a dress. So this is like a drama going on this leela. So don't worry for this. Be happy. Be happy, chant my name and be ecstatic and come to me. So this was the Sarvadharmana Parityaja Mamekam Saranam last moment. He told give up all these things, this mental, physical, all this dharma, karma, jnana, ityadi. You left and take surrender. Don't worry for anything, I will take you. Aanta sarva papilyo mukhi sami maasuta. This is our strong determination to be with the Krishna, to surrender to Krishna and be happy. What is going on? Everything is by his under control of his kala. It's time. No one can free, no one can do anything. He's protecting, he's doing everything. If we surrender to him, we will free from this kala, this death and this suffering. No need to mistress anything else. Okay. Your Premanandi Hare. So Nitalila Pishta Bhakti Balavatirtha Gosai Maharaj ki jai. Nitalila Pishta Bhakti Vayobhuri Gosai Maharaj ki jai. Nitalila Pishta Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj ki jai. Nitalila Pishta Bhakti Vedanta Nanu Swami Maharaj ki jai. Nitalila Bhakti Pradhyam Keshwari Swami Maharaj ki jai. Sapasada Bhakti Nata Prabhupada ki jai. All senior wisdom is ki jai, all devotees ki jai, aur premanandi.
So now Abhimanyu Prabhu, who is a disciple of Bhaktivedanta Gosai Maharaj, will speak for a few minutes, and then we'll have Puspanjali, and then we have Arti and Prasad.
Hey Sri Guru Gandhan Dina Bandha Svananda Dhatta Karanaka Sindho Vrindavana Sinahita Avtara Prasira Rahatana Prachara. So it was 2 years ago that my Gurudev did his pastime of disappearance. You know that the Vaishnavas never really leave their present forever in their words. So I'll share a little bit about the events surrounding his disappearance. And it was quite miraculous. About a week before he disappeared from this world, he did the pastime of having a heart attack, and over the next couple of days his health gradually declined to the point where by the time I got there on April 19th, the doctor said it was impossible for him to be alive. So on the morning of April 20th, I had the fortune of talking to my great ex-godbrother Bhakti Niketan to reassure me, Maharaj. And, you know, he was very glad that I had made it for this part of my Gurudev's pastime. And my Gurudev at that time, he wasn't speaking. He was just, you know, deep in meditation or samadhi. And the devotees had been doing 24-hour kirtan and bhagavatam and chaitanya charitamrita recital for that whole week. So it was, you know, it was kind of like a little Srivasangan all over again. It was just, I remember that night that I stayed there, there wasn't just kirtan going on throughout the night. There was this rip-roaring, ecstatic kirtan, like 2, 3 in the morning. The devotees were just like doing this roaring kirtan. It was really blissful. I just thought, like, man, we could just do this forever. This doesn't have to end. And so I got to see Srila Tarishwami Maharaj. He said, you know, I'm very glad that you've come here, Abhi. And your Gurudev, he's already left. He's in Vasudev Sangha. He's already in the spiritual world serving Krishna. And yet he's just keeping his body here in this world just to engage all of us in performing some kirtan, and also to purify, you know, to purify all of us. You mentioned that even, you know, within our body, all the cells are little individual living entities. So within his body, he's purifying all of those little, those little microscopic living entities by staying here by letting them hear the sankirtan. Since the doctors had said that after his heart attack and after so many of his organs had failed, and since his heartbeat was so low, the doctors had all basically given the verdict that it's a miracle. He's just surviving by his own divine will for some purpose, because it's impossible for a human being to live in a body with that many organs having failed, a heartbeat so low. So my Gurudev showed that he's not really bound by the laws of material nature. He's just here really to benefit us, and just by showing such a pastime, even in his act of disappearing from this world, he's giving auspiciousness to, you know, to all living entities by showing the power of devotional service. And so I'll just end with, Gurudev has this book entitled Guru Tattva, and he starts it with a part of a lecture by Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. When we are impelled to enjoy our senses, like the tongue, hands, legs, arms, and genitals, we are enchanted and then deceived. It is therefore imperative upon us to remember Sri Guru Parapadma at the beginning of each year, each month, and each day, and at every moment, for he can protect us from all such deception. Our Gurudeva's forms are manifold. If he did not manifest himself in various ways, then who else would protect us? That person whom my Gurudeva has accepted as his own is my savior. I do not want to see the faces of vile persons who criticize my Gurudeva or who support those who criticize him. They are the cause of all inauspiciousness. The very instant I deviate from or forget the lotus feet of Srila Gurudeva, who is continuously attracting me to his lotus feet, at that very moment I am unquestionably deprived of the truth. Upon such deviation, I became engrossed in contemplating countless scarcities. My Gurudev constantly protects me from dvitiya abhinivesh, becoming absorbed in activities separate from the interest of Bhagavan. If I do not remember my Gurudev at the beginning of each year, each month, each day, and at every moment, I will surely fall farther away from the path of bhakti. Consequently, I myself will wish to be recognized as Guru, and that sinister contemplation of how others will worship me will invade my mind. This alone is Dvitiya Abhinivesh. Sri Gaurasundara Sri Krishna himself, who came to this earth as Jagad Guru, the spiritual master of the whole world, and spoke Shikshashtika. May the exalted manifest Gurus, Mahanta Gurus, and all great Vaishnavas, who are surrendered to their lotus feet, impart all aspects of the teachings of Shikshashtika to us. May they deliver us from our calamitous situation. From a lecture by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur
Prabhupada.
So now we'll have Pushpanjali. Would anyone would like to do the arti? He will sing. He wants to sing.
You don't want
to? I would prefer to sing if possible.
Everyone can stand and put your seats away in the side so there's some more room. Thanks. Oh, my.
Oh,
Yashomati Nandana Brajavara Nagara
Thank you. Thank you.
So, Prasad will be outside in the hall, so please come take some Prasad.